Vasily Vereshchagin is one of the most famous Russian war artists. He is one of the first Russian artists to be widely recognized abroad. Vereshchagin is also known as the author of 12 books. The most famous of them are the ones about his travels, the wars in Asia and Europe, and the War of 1812.
Born into an aristocratic family in Cherepovets in 1842, Vasily Vereshchagin graduated from the Naval Cadet Corps in St. Petersburg, but he had a strong inclination towards the fine arts. He then enrolled in the Imperial Academy of Arts, now the St. Petersburg Academy of Arts, a school that promoted the neoclassical style and technique.
During his life, Vasily Vereshchagin took part in three major wars that were waged by the Russian Empire. He had his first taste of war at the age of 26 when he accompanied the Russian army on an expedition to Turkestan, modern-day Uzbekistan. He was decorated with the Cross of St. George for bravery shown during the siege of Samarkand. Then he took part in the last Russian-Turkish War 1877-1878 and the Russian-Japanese War, in which he perished aboard the Russian flagship Petropavlovsk in Port Arthur when the battleship was blown up by a mine and on the 13th of April 1904. He traveled a lot. For several years he lived in India, Tibet, Syria, the Philippines, Japan and the USA.
Okay, today I will be talking about what it means to look at paintings as historical documents, or more properly, what paintings can tell us about, might be able to tell us about Kyrgyz and Central Asian history, and what we can and cannot know about the past through visual representations of it. I'll be focusing on the paintings of Vasily Vereshchagin. He was a Russian painter in the late 19th century, who created an iconic set of ethnic portraits known as the Turkestan series, which he produced from 1868 to 1874 as artist in residence of the imperial administration in Tashkent. This was the administrative center of Imperial Turkestan, an area of government set up by the Russian authorities, which encompassed parts of the Kazakh steppe and what we would now call simply Central Asia. At first glance, and you will see a series of Vereshchagin's ethnic portraits as I'm talking, his art seems almost photographic in its attention to detail and in its representation of the most intricate minutiae. There is a high degree of realism as well as a consistent devotion to accuracy. That is to say, the paintings appear as if they are works of art that were able to mirror things as they were in reality. This realism is evident in almost all of his paintings, which are filled with intricately rendered wood engravings, tapestries, fabrics, and other ethnographic detail. All of this is sort of just piled up in front of the spectator in Vereshchagin's paintings. This attention to detail would seem to make these very reliable ethnographic documents. This is how they were described in this manner at the time, and commentators frequently referred to Vereshchagin as an ethnographic painter. In other words, they appear to provide a very accurate visual record of ethnic and historical realities in Central Asia and of the varied ethnic groups whose aspects, modes of dress, and characteristics.
His works are directly related to the impressions he received either by participating in military operations or traveling around the world. For example, after participating in the military campaigns in Asia, Vereshchagin created a Turkestan series of paintings, of which the most famous are such paintings as the prisoners of war, mortally wounded, attacked by surprise. No doubt, the Apotheosis of War is Vereshchagin's best recognized painting. It's considered part of Vereshchagin's Turkestan series. The idea came from the legend that armies from the east would leave pyramids of skulls as a trophy of the conquest. The work sends a strong anti-war message, translating ancient time. The frame of the painting contained a sarcastic message from the writer, dedicated to all great conquerors, past, present, and future. In 1877-1878, Vereshchagin fought in the Russian-Turkish War on the Balkan Peninsula. Though opposed to war, he felt that it was his duty to document it in all its detail. And since the professional of war correspondent had not yet appeared, the artist got around the obstacle by volunteering for active duty. He was wounded several times. Vereshchagin's paintings revealed war viciousness, showing soldiers as the most important element in war and the chief victim of it.
Perhaps the most famous Vereshchagin's picture illustrating the Russian-Turkish War of 1877-1878 is a triptych. At Shipka, all is quiet, as from September to December of 1877, 700 Russian soldiers and officers perished or were wounded, and more than 9,000 were lost because of illnesses and deep frostbite.
Vasily Vereshchagin said that he was unable to paint the triptych as he burst into tears while working at it. In 1884, a trip to India inspired Vasily Vereshchagin to paint the suppression of the Indian revolt by the British. The second name of this painting is Blowing from Guns in British India. It depicts an execution method of tying victims to barrels of cannon.
Although the method had been officially halted decades before the revolt, the soldiers in the painting are wearing the uniforms of the end of the 19th century.
The current whereabouts of the paintings are unknown. Unfortunately, nowadays we can only see some sketches or copies and photos. The painting was bought by British officials at an auction in the United States and destroyed. Of course, the civilized British didn't want other countries to learn how the barbarians of the British Empire were turned into really cultural subjects. In 1887-1900, Vasily Vereshchagin created the series of 20 paintings called 1812. In this series, he demonstrated the great national psyche of the Russians and unmasked Napoleon, showing him to be a cruel invader and a tyrant. We can see Napoleon as a great commander-in-chief in Napoleon near Borodino and Napoleon in despair in Bad News from France.
We can see the great fire of Moscow that Lord George Gordon Byron described in his poem The Age of Bronze, written in 1823. To this the soldiers lent his kindling mage, to this the peasant gave his cottage sage, to this the merchant flung his hoarded store, the prince his hall, and Moscow was no more.
The paintings fire over the Moskvoreche, the return from the Petrov Palace, are shocking. We can see Russian heroes fighting for our fatherland in wait, let them come nearer, captured with arms, shoot them. We can see the French army, the army of the winners in the end of the Battle of Borodino, the army of occupants in at the Assumption Cathedral and shooting in the Kremlin, the defeated army in on the road, retreat and escape.
Looking at all these paintings, everyone can understand how great the patriots defending our country were.
A war artist, an ethnographer, a pacifist, all this war described Vasily Vereshchagin, a famous Russian painter. Vereshchagin was one of the greatest artists of the 19th century, and thus he became not the four only that had great art talent, that is why that had great soul. Vladimir Stasov. Vereshchagin is an enormous person. Vereshchagin is a super artist as well as a superman. Ilya Repin.
He had successful exhibitions outside Russia, but both in Europe and in the USA, the military authorities forbade soldiers and students of military schools to visit the exhibition. He wrote, "To give to a society of the pictures of the present, genuine war is necessary all to experience and to do, to participate in attacks, storms, victories, defeats, to test famine, cold, illness, wounds. I tried always to speak only the truth, and people all over the world have believed his works."